Hello everyone, I'm a tutor. My videos are mostly for beginner PC users. In this video, I will tell you what is DNS. Why does DNS affect the internet connection speed? We will learn how to manually configure DNS. Let's do it on the wire connection. Internet connection has its maximum speed. Each connection has its parameters. Often configured parameters do not allow you to get the maximum connection speed. They make the internet connection work wrong. As a result, the computer is connected to the internet, web pages seem to open normally, but at maximum loads, the speed leaves much to be desired. This is especially evident in online games, for example. It turns out that you paid for this high-speed tariff and you speed like a cheap tariff. It's embarrassing, isn't it? What parameter settings can affect the speed? An important parameter is DNS settings. You probably know, but I will briefly explain how I understand what DNS is. This will be easy to do with an example. When we call someone on the phone, we dial the number of the person we are calling. Phone numbers are hard to remember. Therefore, people came up with a list of contacts on the phone. It's like a personal phone book. In the list, we write down the name of the person and his phone number. After that, just find the right person on the list. Click on it and the phone will dial its number. Let's suppose we enter the name of the site in the address bar of the browser and press enter. We have sent a request. We want the browser to open this site. The name of the site looks like human readable text. Such a name is easy for a person to remember. This is an analog of the name of the subscriber in the telephone contact list. But computers on the internet to which we send this request do not understand the text names of sites. Computers don't work with text words. They understand digital sequences, in other words, numerical label. DNS is like a contact list on the phone. When we enter it, the site name into the browser and press enter, we send this name to the DNS server. The DNS server has a list of all sites. Each site has its numerical label. This numerical label is called an IP address. The DNS server by name determines the site that you want to view. To be more precise, do not the site, but the IP address of this site. As I said, the IP address is a numerical label. This is exactly what computers on the internet understand. This IP address is sent as a request. There are a lot of DNS servers. The user can connect to any of them. Geographically, they are located in different places. The users live in different locations. Depending on where the user lives, his computer may have a different speed of access to certain DNS server. To minimize the delay of sending requests to the internet, you need to choose the fastest DNS server for your location. I greatly simplified, but the essence is true. The theory enough? Where are the DNS settings? There are several ways to open settings. Fastest via system tray. Here we find the icon for the connecting to the internet. When the computer is connected to the internet with a wire, the icon looks like this. Right-click icon and select Open Network and Internet Settings. A window of parameters has opened in the Advanced Network Settings section. Select Change Adapter Options. A window opens showing the network adapters on this computer. This PC has a local Ethernet adapter. In other words, wire connection. Note, Ethernet is not internet. It's not the same thing. You might have other adapters here. For example, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth. They will look like this. You can tell the status of adapter by looking at it. Now the status is connected to the internet. The adapter may have a different status. For example, network cable unplugged. Now it's not about that. The computer is connected to the internet by wire. So we are interested in this particular adapter. To see its settings, right click and select properties. Here we are interested in a TCP/IP v4 protocol. This protocol is most widely used today. It is used by most ISPs. I selected this setting, click the properties button. The protocol properties open. Here are the IP address settings. In my case, a router is connected to the internet. It distributed IP addresses automatically to all devices on my home network, including this computer. You might have the same settings or some IP address can be entered. In any case, we do not touch the IP address settings. We are interested in the DNS server settings at the bottom. In my case, the computer also automatically receives DNS from the router. I don't know what settings you have, if also automatically, continue. If you have servers configured here, you can overwrite their values. You can type them into the text document. Attention! By changing the internet connection settings, you take full responsibility for what you do. If you do everything right, these instructions works great. If you make any mistakes during setup, your internet connection may be lost. I recommend that beginners create the system restore point before setting up. You can configure DNS servers manually. You can find a list of the most popular DNS servers on the web. In the description of the video, I added some of them to manually configure the DNS. Check use the following DNS server addresses. Now you can type in the DNS server address here. I will open the video description. In full description. For example, I will set up this Cloudflare service. Select DNS, preferred DNS. Right click. Copy. Roll down the window. Right click. Paste. The preferred DNS server is configured. In the second field, an alternative DNS server and do the same. I copy alternate DNS and paste into the second field. OK. Close. That's it. I manually configured the DNS server on the properties of the wired internet connection. To check the new settings, you can click on this properties button. Below we see the newly configured DNS servers. After setting up, restart your computer. After that, you can check if there are any changes in the operation of your internet. You can just play some online game. You might want to return the settings to their original state. It can be done like this. This time I will open the adapter options in different way. Click on the Windows icon. Here settings. Network and internet. Here you can click not this button, but Ethernet. And here click change adapter options. I open properties of the necessary adapter. I select TCP/IP v4 properties. If you have registered any of your servers, then you can simply type them here. If it was configured automatically, like mine, then just select this option. After setting up, restart your computer. In Windows 11, the DNS settings open a little differently. Right click on the network connection icon. Choose this option. I am setting up a wired network. Here I choose Ethernet. Ethernet settings open. A little lower, there is a DNS server assignment. Automatic DHCP enabled. I press edit. Click on the drop-down list. Choose the manual. Here I switch to the right IPv4. You can paste or type DNS servers into these fields. This time I'll use Google's DNS. I'll just type it them. Windows 11 has encryption settings. It's better to choose this one. Encrypted traffic is preferred and unencrypted traffic is also supported. Here I do the same. Click Save. That's it. Returning to the original settings, it's easier. I'll open the DNS settings differently. Right-click on the Windows icon. I choose Network Connections, Ethernet, DNS Server Assignment Edit. Here I simply select Automatic DHCP. Save. That's it. The setting what I showed, in some cases, it can significantly increase the connection speed and reduce ping. In the video I said that you need to choose the fastest DNS server for use. There are simple programs what allow you to quickly find the fastest DNS in semi-automatic mode. If you want to deal with such a program, support this video with your wonderful likes. Thanks for watching my videos. If the video are helpful, please like, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss the next video. Perhaps the video will be useful to your friends. Please share with them. I wish health to all viewers. My name is Evgeny Yurtaev. See you soon.